Manatees are well adapted to their environment, and that would include even when hurricanes come. But because they're so powerful and the waves can get so high and the changes can be so dramatic, they are a great risk to manatees. When the storm surges come in, it raises the water level many feet, and it can actually cause manatees to go way inland in an area that they would not normally inhabit. And when the water recedes, they can become trapped in those areas, and we have to really watch out for them and make sure that we can give them the attention they need and, if necessary, rescue them. In some circumstances, it's not the high water that causes problems for manatees, but it's actually the water leaving an area, which is part of their natural habitat, and stranding them, such as when a hurricane comes in and pulls the water out of a bay, like happened in Tampa Bay. Although manatees are well adapted to handling different situations, even like hurricanes, it can still be very stressful, and a young calf who's just not very strong can easily be separated from its mother. So it's especially important to look out for calves after a hurricane has passed and make sure that they're not left stranded in that waterway, because they couldn't survive as a young calf. Some specific examples of what can happen is that you have ponds that are in place that are not connected to the coastal waters. During hurricanes, the water levels come up so high that even places like golf course ponds become areas that can entrap manatees when the water goes back down. We know of specific ponds where manatees have been entrapped in them more than one time, and then that do require being rescued. Besides manatees being directly affected by being stranded with high water, they can also affect their habitat, because when these hurricanes come in, there's all kinds of other pollution that actually gets within those systems and can cause major algal blooms or other contaminations. So it's also going to be important to pay attention to what's happened after the hurricanes and whether it's affected the seagrasses manatees feed on, or that causes algal blooms. So there are a lot of other things that can happen down the road after a hurricane has passed. Once it's safe to be out and around after a hurricane, do look at the waterways and look for signs that a manatee might have become entrapped in an area, and be sure and report it to your local government agency. And in Florida, you'd want to report it to the Florida Fish and Wildlife Conservation Commission.